Today, we're diving into gyroscopic instruments, a crucial part of an aircraft's flight instruments. These instruments are built on the principles of gyroscopic motion, and they play a huge role in maintaining situational awareness, especially when flying in low visibility or instrument meteorological conditions. Here's what we will cover today: the basic principles of gyroscopic motion, the main gyroscopic instruments, the attitude indicator, heading indicator, and the turn coordinator, how these instruments work, and what issues you might encounter. By the end of this video, you'll have a solid grasp of how these instruments function and why they are so critical for safe flight. To understand gyroscopic instruments, we first need to understand what a gyroscope is. So, what exactly is a gyroscope? Well, it's a spinning wheel or disc mounted so it can pivot freely in one or more directions. The term gyroscope comes from the Greek words gyros, meaning circle or rotation, and scopen, meaning to look or to observe. Combined, the term essentially means to observe rotation. The gyroscope was named by the French physicist Léon Foucault in 1852 during his experiments demonstrating the Earth's rotation. A great example of a gyroscope in action is a spinning top. When stationary, a top will simply topple if you try to balance it vertically. But when it's spinning, it balances beautifully until it slows down and topples again. So what keeps the spinning top balanced? It's the very properties of a gyroscope, which have fascinating applications in aviation. Gyroscopes have two fundamental properties that make them invaluable in aviation and beyond. Number one, rigidity in space. When a gyroscope spins, its axis remains fixed in space, regardless of how its mounting moves. This principle is called rigidity in space. For example, think of a spinning top. As long as it's spinning, its axis stays steady and upright. However, when the spin slows down, the top loses its rigidity and topples over. The rigidity of a gyroscope depends on two factors: mass. A larger mass increases rigidity. Spin rate. The faster the gyroscope spins, the more rigid it becomes. Number two, precession. Precession occurs when a force is applied to a spinning gyroscope. Interestingly, the resulting motion doesn't happen directly when the force is applied. Instead, the reaction occurs 90 degrees ahead in the direction of the gyroscope's rotation. This delayed reaction is known as gyroscopic precession. Rigidity and precession are inversely related. A more rigid gyroscope exhibits less precession, and a less rigid gyroscope will show more precession. Now, these two principles, rigidity in space and precession, are incredibly important in aviation. They are what make the three main gyroscopic flight instruments work: the attitude indicator, the heading indicator, and the turn coordinator. The attitude indicator shows the aircraft's pitch, nose up or nose down, and bank, roll, relative to the horizon. It's one of the most critical instruments for maintaining spatial orientation, especially in instrument meteorological conditions. At the heart of the attitude indicator is a gyroscope, a spinning wheel that stays stable thanks to the gyroscope's property of rigidity in space. Here's how it functions. Inside the instrument, there is a gyroscope mounted horizontally. It spins at very high speed, usually between 10,000 and 20,000 revolutions per minute. This gyro stays fixed in its orientation while the aircraft moves around it. The instrument's gimbal system translates this stability into the artificial horizon display you see on the indicator. The gyro is usually powered by suction from a vacuum pump. The pump pulls air through small nozzles or ports around the gyroscope. As the air flows past vanes of the gyroscope, it spins the wheel at high speed. The stable gyroscope then provides a reference for the aircraft's pitch and bank. While the attitude indicator is highly reliable, there are some limitations and potential errors to be aware of. The instrument has specific limits to its operation: a pitch limit of around 60 degrees and a bank limit of approximately 100 to 110 degrees. If these limits are exceeded, the gyro can tumble, resulting in incorrect readings. Modern instruments are designed to minimize this issue, but it's still a limitation. Rapid changes in speed, such as during takeoff or turbulence, can temporarily tilt the gyro. This might lead to false pitch indications until the gyro stabilizes again. Understanding how the attitude indicator works, along with its limitations, will help you use it effectively and safely, especially in challenging flight conditions. Let's talk about the heading indicator, an instrument that works hand in hand with the magnetic compass to make reading magnetic headings much easier. This instrument also relies on a gyroscope to function. Inside the heading indicator, there's a gyroscope mounted horizontally that spins along the vertical axis. The gyroscope is aligned to maintain a constant directional reference. Once you manually align it with the magnetic compass on a particular heading, the gyroscope's rigidity keeps it steady. As the aircraft turns, the instrument uses the gyroscope's stability to rotate the compass card relative to the aircraft, providing an accurate heading during both straight flights and turns. The gyroscope in the heading indicator is powered by the vacuum pump in most general aviation aircraft. Just like the attitude indicator, the vacuum system spins the gyro using directed airflow. One thing to keep in mind is that the heading indicator doesn't automatically adjust for the Earth's rotation. This means you will need to periodically realign it with the magnetic compass during flight. The big advantage? Unlike the magnetic compass, the heading indicator isn't affected by magnetic dip or acceleration errors, making it much easier to read in flight. Common errors to watch for are gyro drift. Over time, friction and small imperfections in the gyro can cause it to drift, so you need to periodically adjust and realign it with the magnetic compass. And turn errors, precession, a property of gyroscopes, can sometimes lead to minor inaccuracies during turns, but these are usually small and manageable. By understanding how the heading indicator works and its limitations, you can use it effectively to maintain accurate navigation during your flights. Let's talk about the turn coordinator, specifically the rate of turn indicator within it. This instrument shows how quickly the aircraft is turning, or its rate of turn. The turn coordinator works a bit differently from the attitude and heading indicators because its gyro is mounted at an angle about 30 degrees from the horizontal plane. This unique mounting allows it to sense both the rate of yaw, how fast the aircraft is turning, and some degree of roll. Here's how it works. When the aircraft turns, the gyroscope resists the motion due to its rigidity in space. This resistance causes the gyro to tilt slightly, and through the property of precession, this tilt moves the needle or indicator on the instrument face. The turn coordinator is calibrated to show a standard rate turn when the needle aligns with the marked indicator. A standard rate turn means the aircraft will complete a full 360-degree turn in exactly 2 minutes. The turn coordinator is often powered differently from other gyroscopic instruments. Many modern aircraft use an electrically driven gyroscope for this instrument. An electric motor spins the gyro, which eliminates reliance on the vacuum pump. This design provides redundancy, so even if the vacuum pump fails, which would affect the attitude and heading indicators, the turn coordinator remains operational, ensuring you still have a reliable instrument for turns. Common errors to watch for are turbulence. Turbulence can cause the indicator to give temporary erratic readings, making it harder to interpret. If the electrical system powering the turn coordinator fails, the instrument will stop functioning. By understanding the turn coordinator's unique design and limitations, you can rely on it confidently, especially as a backup during critical phases of flight. Let's dive into some fascinating aspects of gyroscopic errors that become particularly noticeable during longer flights, especially when crossing multiple latitudes and longitudes. Understanding these errors is essential for accurate navigation. First, let's discuss gyro wander, which is essentially the drifting of a gyro's axis away from its set position. This wander can occur for two main reasons: apparent wander and real drift. Apparent wander is an illusion created by Earth's rotation and isn't due to any malfunction in the gyro. To understand this, imagine a gyro aligned with the longitudinal north-south axis at a specific latitude and longitude. Thanks to the principle of rigidity in space, the gyro remains fixed in its position. However, As the Earth rotates, the orientation of the longitudes shift relative to the rigidly held gyro. This creates the appearance that the gyro's axis is drifting when viewed from the pilot's perspective. This effect is most pronounced at the poles, where the rate of apparent wander equals the Earth's rotation rate of 15 degrees per hour. At the equator, there's no apparent wander because the meridians are parallel. When an aircraft moves east or west, it also experiences a related phenomenon known as transport wander, which occurs due to the gyro being physically transported across the spherical surface of the Earth. In practice, pilots must periodically reset the directional gyro using a magnetic compass or other references, especially during long flights. The latitude nut, an internal component of the directional gyro, helps compensate for this drift at specific latitudes. However, it's only adjusted during installation or maintenance and doesn't account for significant changes in latitude during flight, necessitating manual corrections. Unlike apparent wander, real drift is an actual change in the gyro's axis caused by physical factors. Friction in the gimbals, mechanical wear, or temperature fluctuations can all contribute to real drift. Over time, these effects accumulate, making periodic adjustments necessary to maintain accuracy. Another source of error stems from acceleration. When an aircraft accelerates or decelerates, the sudden forces can momentarily tilt the gyro, causing a small deviation. It's similar to how a car tilts forward or backward when braking or accelerating. These minor tilts can lead to temporary drift, but are typically corrected through routine realignments. Let's shift our focus to errors on the vertical axis, specifically apparent topple. This occurs when a vertically oriented gyro appears to tilt or topple as the Earth rotates beneath it. Again, the gyro itself remains rigid in space, but the observer perceives this apparent tilt due to the rotation of the Earth. This phenomenon is most noticeable near the equator, where the vertical axis gyro seems to topple as the Earth moves. Like apparent wander, it's not a true mechanical fault, but an optical illusion. On the other hand, real topple occurs when friction or sudden external forces like turbulence, sharp turns, or temperature changes cause the gyro to physically tilt. To simplify, gyros aligned to the vertical axis, for example the artificial horizon, are primarily affected by topple. Gyros aligned to the horizontal axis, for example the directional gyro, can experience both drift and topple. Knowing these tendencies allows pilots to anticipate and correct these errors effectively. By resetting instruments periodically and understanding the principles at play, we ensure accurate data for safe and reliable flight operations. As we move on from conventional gyroscopic instruments, let's talk about the modern advantages that have revolutionized navigation. Laser gyros. These are a game changer in aviation and beyond. Unlike traditional mechanical gyros, which rely on spinning disks, laser gyroscopes use light to measure angular rotation. The laser gyros operate on the Sagnac effect. This principle was discovered by French physicist Georges Sagnac in 1913. He demonstrated that when beams of light travel in opposite directions around a closed loop, the time it takes for each beam to complete the loop changes when the system rotates. This tiny difference in time is proportional to the rotation, allowing laser gyroscopes to measure angular motion with remarkable precision. In modern aircraft, three laser gyroscopes are typically used, one for each axis: pitch, roll, and yaw. These gyros are essential components of the Inertial Reference System, IRS, which provides crucial data about the aircraft's position, altitude, velocity, and heading. The IRS uses these gyros along with accelerometers to measure changes in the aircraft's orientation and movement relative to the Earth. Since the IRS operates independently of external signals, it ensures precise navigation even in areas where GPS signals may be unavailable, such as over the ocean or in remote locations. This data is then integrated into the Flight Management System, FMS, enabling the aircraft to navigate with exceptional accuracy over long distances. Laser gyroscopes offer several key advantages. since they have no moving parts, there are no components subject to mechanical wear, contributing to their durability and reliability. They also provide high levels of accuracy, making them ideal for complex navigation systems. Their compact size and lightweight nature are ideal for modern applications, where minimizing space and weight is a priority. Laser gyroscopes are also integral to the Attitude and Heading Reference System, AHRS, in smaller or newer aircraft. The AHRS replaces traditional gyroscopic instruments, like the attitude and heading indicators, and provides real-time digital outputs for the aircraft's orientation. This system is not only more compact, but also free from the maintenance challenges associated with traditional gyros. Modern fly-by-wire systems in both commercial and military jets rely on laser gyroscopes. These systems monitor angular rates to enhance stability and control, particularly during high-speed or complex maneuvers. In military aviation, laser gyros are vital for navigation in GPS-denied environments, where their precision is crucial for mission-critical operations. Spacecraft use laser gyroscopes in their attitude control and navigation systems to maintain precise orientation in orbit and hopefully someday on interplanetary travel. Laser gyroscopes also find use in drones and automatic vehicles. Drones rely on them for stability and navigation, while autonomous cars utilize them for high-precision inertial navigation in environments where GPS signals may be weak or unavailable, such as tunnels or urban canyons. The reliability and precision of laser gyroscopes have made them essential for modern navigation and control systems. By eliminating the limitations of traditional mechanical gyros, they have revolutionized navigation in aviation, space exploration, and beyond. Whether guiding a commercial airliner across the globe, stabilizing a spacecraft in orbit, or ensuring a drone stays on course, laser gyroscopes are integral to the success of these critical systems. And that's a wrap on gyroscopic instruments. These devices are absolutely essential for safe flying, especially when you're in the clouds. Always cross-check your instruments, stay aware of potential failures, and keep practicing your skills. If you found this video helpful, be sure to hit the like button. Drop your questions, experiences, or suggestions for future topics in the comments below and share it with your fellow aviation enthusiasts. If you can answer the questions in the description, you're building a solid understanding of gyroscopic instruments and their behavior. Thanks for watching. And remember, your mastery of these systems is crucial for handling challenges in the sky with confidence. Safe flying.